where all the magic happens. This is our converging diverging nozzle. Without this, you don't have a hypersonic wind tunnel.
Chris Combs runs the hypersonics lab at the University of Texas, San Antonio, home to a new state-of-the-art Mach 7 wind tunnel, a key tool in helping the U.S. catch up to China and Russia, and developing weapons that travel more than five times the speed of sound. Hypersonic missiles and aircraft could be the future of warfare because their speeds and maneuverability make them extremely difficult to defend against.
We're one of only about five in U.S. academia that can do Mach 7 plus.
And there's only a handful of government-run, industrial-grade hypersonic wind tunnels in the U.S. In fact, during a meeting with the defense secretary in February, two people in the room told CNN that CEOs of America's largest defense contractors described this scarcity of wind tunnels as a choke point in testing.
For the big wind tunnel facilities, it can be 1-2 year wait time right now to schedule things out. I'd say 6 months would be pretty fast.
A critical delay, as the U.S. is still in the early stages of its hypersonics program, with the Air Force successfully testing Lockheed Martin's missile, called Arrow, last week after three failures. But Russia isn't just testing these weapons. It just became the first country to ever actually use hypersonic weapons in war, using them at least 10 times in Ukraine, according to the Pentagon.
It's a consequential weapon.
And China successfully tested a hypersonic weapon that orbited the globe last year.
At one point, the Chinese were building their wind tunnels as quickly as we were decommissioning wind tunnels.
Mark Lewis, a former top Pentagon official working on hypersonics, estimates Beijing is building a new hypersonic wind tunnel every 6 months.
We really need our test infrastructure, our wind tunnels, in order to be able to advance in this field. And frankly, we've allowed that capability to atrophy over the past few years.
This tunnel in Texas is only 8 inches wide and took about 3 years to build. The biggest hypersonic wind tunnels are 8 feet wide and would take about 5 to 10 years to build, according to Combs.
You're not putting a full-size airplane test vehicle in any of these facilities. There's nobody in the world that's testing in a 20-foot hypersonic wind tunnel, right? That type of technology just doesn't exist. It's simply too much air.
So instead, they test small 3D printed models. These are the ones that are unclassified.
These are the models that you can show us. How many models do you have that you can't show us?
Well, I can't tell you that, right? And this is the type of thing that we can have in our wind tunnel when CNN is here.
Now, in terms of how long it would take to catch up, this hypersonic wind tunnel took about 3 years to build, but the big ones could take anywhere from 5 to 10 years. And China is building a new one almost every 6 months. Kristin Fisher, CNN, at the University of Texas, San Antonio.